Flexible subassembly. Default rigid subassembly can be defined as the flexible subassembly. Designers can easily verify the motion of the whole assembly. This is an excavator assembly with several flexible subassemblies. Now you can drag any part to verify the motion. First, let's check out this tie rod assembly. It contains two components. The rod can be moved along the sleeve. Back to parent assembly. The subassembly can be moved as a group, since the default status of subassembly is rigid. But the rod component can't be moved individually. Select the subassembly, then make it flexible. The icon is changed. Now the rod component can be moved. Go to upper level assembly. This arm subassembly also is rigid as a group by default. Make it a flexible subassembly. Then the individual component can be dragged or rotated. So the concentric constraint can be added between the rod component and another subassembly. Now the assembly can move as desired. For other subassemblies, we could make them flexible and add the suitable constraints between them as required. This is the final well-defined assembly. It contains several flexible subassemblies and has a very clear assembly structure. Designers can drag any component to verify the motion of the whole assembly. Flexible subassembly makes assembly design more reasonable and more flexible.